just then?
Lunch was jammed. There was a line outside. Nobody's here right now because it's the middle of the afternoon.
It is?
I was about to ask you how your lunch with Dave went, but I guess there's no need. You're still floating around in the clouds.
Oh, he is the best, Dave.
At what?
What are you doing?
I thought I'd just put my arms around you.
Why?
Well, I didn't know I needed a reason to, but if I do, because I saw how upset you were right over there. What is it, because we struck out with Markham's boyfriend?
He's the only answer, Scott.
Well, maybe there's another way to prove that Vince is innocent.
We gave up on Bernie too easily, Scott.
Easy? What was so easy about that?
Hello, Mayor's Police. Cheryl speaking.
Hey, little lady. Do you know who this is?
No, no, I'm not too sure.
It's Bernie from the garage. I've been thinking it over, and I guess we should talk.
Terrific.
Without that boyfriend of yours, yes?
Yeah.
Okay. How about if I call you later? Maybe you'd want to buy me a drink someplace.
Okay, sounds good.
Catch you later, Delphi.
Bye.
It's you sitting up.
Oh, I get a little bored lying down. Besides, I'm feeling better. Your witchcraft worked.
Now, careful. Just take it easy.
This feels good.
You don't have to rush it, you know.
Well, I'll tell you one thing I'm going to do. I am going to take a shower and wash this junk off, and then get out of here. Mm-hmm.
Do me a favor. Do not rush into what got you into this fix in the first place, which is living like one of the poor homeless people.
I'm not going to be homeless too long. I'm going to prove my innocence, that I was framed by your friend Reginald.
Vince, we have to talk.
Come on, let's hide the bag.
Please, wait.
Mary, I've already put you through too much.
I wish you'd stop thinking like
that. Look, you can really get in trouble hiding me like this, and I'm feeling better, so it's time I get on the road.
No.
Where'd that come from?
I just don't want you to leave.
Oh, wait a minute. I get it.
Get what?
You want me to stay because I'm a threat to your precious Reginald.
No.
You're afraid I'm going to hurt him.
No, Vince.
Oh, come on, Mary. Admit it, will you? You're worried about him.
I don't like to see people get hurt.
Oof, isn't that touching?
What do you have to gain by confronting him?
How can you even ask me that?
He's not well.
I'm supposed to worry about his health after all the lies he's told, after all the lives he's ruined? Oh, come on.
What is there for you in getting revenge?
Scum like him has to be stopped.
Isn't there anything that I could say that would get you to stay?
So you don't have to worry about your precious Reginald? Mary, why should I?
Because there is more to it than that.
Oh, yeah? Like what?
Like you are not well enough to go outside, like it's raining like crazy out there, and I don't think you're strong enough, and I think that you need a lot more rest, and I don't want to see you get sick again, and if anything happened to you, I would really get upset, and that's not because of him, that's because of you, and can't you believe that?
All right.
All right, what?
All right, I'll stay a few more days.
You will?
Yeah, I mean, you always could talk me into stuff.
Oh, well, oh, thank you. I can't tell you how relieved I am. I'm going to go back to Mary's place. I think it's important that I show up there because that way everything looks normal.
Thank you.
has to be something I can do.
Well, Vince has a decent head on his shoulders. It'll be okay.
Maybe.
Are you sure there isn't something else going on?
What else could there be?
Feelings. Yours about Vince? Could it be they're coming back?
No. I don't know.
Well, which is it? No, or I don't know.
The last few days, I feel I've gotten to see another side of him.
Yeah?
Well, I see a man who can be warm and caring and funny and sensitive. I think I understand why I would have married him.
That would stir up some feelings, old and new.
Makes everything very difficult. Hi, honey.
How's Dan? Have you talked to him? Is he doing okay?
What do you mean? What's going on?
The newspaper. Have you seen this?
No, Peter. Oh, my.
Dad must have hit the ceiling, huh?
He's not supposed to get upset.
I think I'm going to go over there right now.
Yeah, Scott, that's a good idea.
Yeah? Since when do you think it's a great idea that I'm with Reginald Love?
Well, Scott, you're always telling me to be more fair. I'm just trying to change.
I think it's a great idea, too. I think he'd be very happy to see you. Yeah. You should do it.
Okay, I'm going to go over for a little while. I'll be right back.
Okay, bye. No, Mary's place.
Is this Detective Cheryl?
Excuse me?
Just kidding. This is Bernie. Are you still interested in seeing me?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, sure. I figured you might be.
Where are you?
The pig whistle.
Okay, the pig whistle. All right, sounds good. I'll see you in a little bit.
Okay, so long, pal.
Okay.
Have more cases than they know what to do with. The death of a prostitute is hardly going to cause a ripple. What a world, huh, Mary? Mary?
Oh, sorry. What?
Are you okay? I mean, what's on your mind? Anything I can help with?
Oh, no. I'm just worrying about, you know.
Hey, do you know where Cheryl's at?
Well, I saw her, sure, but she left.
You know where she went?
No, I didn't ask her. Why don't you ask Maisie? She's in the kitchen. Okay?
Yeah, thanks. Hey, Maisie.
Hi, honey.
You know where Cheryl is?
Well, I think I do. It's kind of strange, though.
What is?
Well, I heard her on the telephone saying something about the pig whistle.
Why would you... Excuse me. Mm-hmm.
You're a nice kid.
And I think you're a nice man.
I am. But then there's your boyfriend.
My boyfriend?
I can't stand him.
Why not?
He's got some bad attitude.
Look, Bernie, you have nothing to worry about. He's not really my boyfriend.
You wouldn't be kidding me, would you?
No. We've just gone out a couple of times, that's all.
So there are no strings?
No, I'm a free woman.
You are a real pretty woman.
I wouldn't be here if I weren't free.
Ah. You're here, that's for sure.
And I'm having fun.
Oh, it could get a whole lot more fun than this, though.
I like you, Bernie.
I could show you more fun than you ever dreamed of.
That might be nice, Bernie. But first, I'd like to ask you a couple of questions. You said we could talk.
Sure, we can talk. And then we'll get down to the fun.
I'm gonna find him. I I don't care if it takes forever.
It takes forever.
You're here.
Well, yeah, I was in the kitchen. Would you do me a favor?
You taste that?
Mm.
It isn't too salty.
No, it's very good.
Oh, good.
What?
You hold this?
Thank you. Vince.
Huh?
Did you do this?
Looks pretty good, huh?
It looks lovely. I thought you were gone.
Well, you were wrong.
I was just about to go out on the street searching for you. I thought you were gone. How could you do that to me?
I'm sorry.
Sorry doesn't do it. How could you trick me like that?
Well, I didn't want to upset you.
Hiding in the kitchen? Don't you think you're just a little bit too grown up for games like that?
Listen, I just wanted to show you how grateful I am to you.
Yeah, so that's how you do it, by scaring me half to death.
You were really going to run after me?
Yeah, of course I was going to run after you. What did you expect me to do? Walk in and say, would you look at that? Vince has taken a powder. Well, I guess that's just the way it goes sometimes. You know, you win a few, you lose a few. Of course I went looking for you. I thought you were gone.
I was, almost. I got as far as the elevator.
Why did you come back?
Well, I realized that I hadn't done anything to say thank you. So I got to thinking, what can I do? I said, well, I could build us some nice bookshelves, but I figured, wait a minute, that's going to take a little too long. So I decided to make you a wonderful dinner.
I hope you're a good cook.
A lot better than you are.
Wait a minute.
Whoa, and I just mean that also I didn't want to leave you on an empty stomach. You know what I mean?
Gone to a lot of trouble.
Well, I wanted it to be special because, you know, I am going to be leaving you in a few days. And you have been really good to me, Mary.
I didn't do so much.
No, hey, you just hid me in your apartment and hid me in your closet and nursed me back to health with that smelly hot dog. Whatever it was, it worked. So, I made you your favorite.
My favorite?
Coco Vin.
It still is.
Mm-hmm. Now just sit there, huh? I want you to hear something I found. Huh? Tell me if you recognize this. Do you? It's the first song we ever danced to. Don't you remember it, Mary? I will never forget that church social. I saw you sitting across that dance hall. It took me about 10 minutes to get the guts up to go over, you know? Well, I finally did. I went over and I had the sweaty palms, wobbling knees, the whole bit. I got there and I said, can we have this dance? Don't you remember?
No. But are you asking me again now?